venomous snakes. Sorry, Kevin, goodbye. We're getting rid of them all. We're doing ball pythons and pine snakes.
We're gonna go the snakes discovery route. We're gonna set up a hognose snake today.
He's so cute, I just wanna... I can't touch him, I can't touch him, he's too dangerous. Oh, did you see that? Holy smokes. Oh, he's not where I thought he was. This is the most dangerous time to be looking for a snake. When you thought he was one spot, and then he's in the other. What is going on, my beautiful people? Welcome back to my wildlife. We're hanging out in the Serpentarium surrounded by my dangerous venomous reptiles, but they're only dangerous if you do dangerous things around them. I'll tell you what, everything I do on this channel, to a degree, actually, we all know, everything I do is very dangerous. Whether it's jumping off a boat, jumping out of trees, catching crocodiles, messing with venomous snakes, or just plain being me, being silly and clumsy and falling and hurting myself. I start to notice here and there on YouTube starts to demonetize certain videos that they claim is a dangerous act. And on their check system, when you're trying to get monetized for videos, they give you the option to put dangerous acts in a professional setting. And I usually do that. And yesterday, I got my video demonetized. I'm like, ugh. I was just talking about how I'm having problems trying to make money, trying to build this place out. And then bam, this video is demonetized. So I'm thinking, what could it be? Me drinking swamp water, me messing with a king cobra, or coming at the camera with a chainsaw begging you guys to buy merchandise. I don't know what it could be. I don't know. I'm a pretty safe person. But all I gotta say is that today we're gonna keep it nice and simple. We're gonna go the snake's discovery route. We're gonna set up a hognose snake today. See, we got Elite Cage. Shout out to Elite. Thank you for the free enclosure. No, it's not a paid sponsorship. I wish, but they just gave me this beautiful free enclosure. Anyways, I'm getting off track. Take a look at what we have yonder right here. A lot of you guys have been wanting to see my boy Leonardo DiCaprio. And if you don't know who he is, this is my boy Leonardo. He is a hognose snake. He is a beautiful specimen. We're gonna use protective gloves. We got a big gauntlet right here to protect myself because you never know when this little boy I used the hand with the glove. Gotta remember, I don't wanna get demonetized. Okay, we're gonna use the glove. Go nice and safe, nice and safe. There we go. There we go. We got the squiggly boy. There he is. There you go. That's a Western hognose rear fang snake. Not deadly venomous unless you're allergic to venom like Dingo Dinkleman. But the thing is about these guys is they love to eat toads. And the thing about toads is, oh no, I don't wanna get demonetized. I put my bare hands on them. Anyways, the thing about these guys is they got rear fangs. They're used to pop toads because when a toad is about to get eaten by a hognose snake, they puff up with air saying, I'm big, look at me, you can't swallow me now. But they have those rear fangs kind of like daggers to deflate the toad, pop them, and then swallow them whole. Look at him, he's so cute, I just wanna, I can't touch him, he's too dangerous. Look at him, he's gonna nose at me right now. Did you see that? Holy smokes. Let's relax now. Let's just put him back. This is his old enclosure. As you can see, it is whack. Look at this thing. Look at it. Aspen, water dish, whack. Just kidding. That's plenty for a hognose. He doesn't really care what's in there. As long as he's got food and water, a nice place to hide, and good temperatures. But we're gonna upgrade him today. We got this Elite Cage. What we're gonna do is use this custom reptile enclosure for Mr. Leonardo DiCaprio. As you can see, it's got a nice, beautiful tropical climate in the background. Obviously not where you find hognose snakes. Typically, hognose snakes like the Western hognose, you find in Western United States, nice dry prairie habitat. And then you got the Eastern hognose that likes to live down in Florida, North Florida. And they typically like that more humid habitat, but they're not being found in any tropical forests like down in South Florida, only more so North Mid Florida. So these guys, typically, you want to set up in something with like aspen, nice and dry, so they're nice and happy. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this aspen, we're gonna set up this enclosure, and I'm gonna show you guys how to safely set up a hognose enclosure, because that's, we're changing things up. Getting rid of all these venomous snakes. Sorry, Kevin, goodbye. We're getting rid of them all. We're doing ball pythons and pine snakes. We're doing it right. We're doing it safe because chainsaws and king cobras just don't work on this channel anymore. All right, so we're gonna fill this up with aspen a whole bunch so he can bury himself in here. There's a big dish so you can have lots of substrate if you're gonna do like a bioactive or, listen, we gotta keep it safe. I don't wanna get demonetized. I need to keep making money to build this place out. Don't film him. He's doing his thing. He still lives here. He still pays rent. He can be in the video. I mean, he can't be in the video. Don't film him, okay? So anyways, look at this nice safe enclosure. Look, we don't even put a locking system on it. There's no lock. You could potentially put a lock, but just little handles, because it's just a hognose snake. Nothing to worry about. We're just gonna fill up the rest of this little area. Look at that.
This is great. This is, right, Kevin? Don't film Kevin. Don't film Kevin. Anyway, so what we're going to do now is get the Leaps custom light. Sponsor me, Leaps. Sponsor me. This is not a paid promotion. This sponsors the light. Look at the light. It's a great light. Look at that. We have the custom Leap light on the top with the Leap enclosure. You could say I'm leaping. I'm so happy. Kevin, please don't attack me. All right, beautiful people, we have a nice selection of hides, because don't forget, your snake needs water, needs food, needs supplemental heating, and it needs a good place to hide. Look at all these great selections. Look at this, you could go with Rocky Outcrop, strong Rocky Aussie Outcrop right there. You could go with a Western Desert Stone. Look at that, like limestone. You could go thin wood, for the guys who don't like the thick wood, or the ladies who don't like the thicker wood. This is the thin type. Or you could go all out and give your hog nose the best paradise in town. Look at that. It's a castle. Yeah, it's a castle. Oh, you don't give your hog nose snakes castles. Oh, Kevin, you want a castle? You can't be in the video. Anyways, nice castle. Usually these things are for aquariums with fish and whatnot. You probably want to avoid using stuff like this if you have a real small hog nose or a real small snake. Because these little holes, these little entrances here and there, potentially your snake could get stuck. So we're not gonna actually use that. Oh! See, this is why you don't use the thin stuff. It breaks. You need the thick wood, boys and girls, thick wood. Oh, see, it won't stop breaking. Anyway, so we also have this. I like to call this the staircase to heaven. Look at that. It's nothing to get stuck in, perfect. Let's give this hognose a staircase to heaven because of that beautiful, beautiful lighting. Look at that. It's heavenly. Hallelujah. Now, like I said, they're from the Western United States. It's like prairie habitat. It's a little brown and dull. Maybe not used to green stuff, but look at this. We're giving him a tropical paradise. This is Chandler's wild world. So we want to make sure he feels like he's in the Costa Rican jungle. We don't want him to feel like he's a Western hognose. We want to make him feel like he's a Madagascan hognose. Like he's real tropical, he's exotic. Got another little plant here, weighted down just in case your hognose is a little wrecking machine tearing everything down. Look at that. Have a look at that. Hey Kevin, have a look at that. They call me modern day Picasso. You can't be in the video, but they call me modern day Picasso. Look at that. Oh, the color variation. Leonardo, you don't even know what you're getting into, baby. And then the water dish. He had a smaller water dish. Why don't we give him a massive water dish? This is actually like a swimming pool. This is an infinity pool. I'm gonna go clean this. We're gonna put it right there. And then bing, bong, bang, you got a hot glue set up. How do you like that, Kevin? Hey, I love you. Not in the shot. All right, so anyways, we got a nice water dish. Beautiful water, beautiful. The best water you can buy.
Hooray!
Wow, look at that. Look at this. You could go with your typical log top sliding enclosure. You could go with that. It's pretty secure. Or you could go with this. Bam. Have a look at that. Sponsor me, Leap. Sponsor me. I need money. And YouTube keeps demonetizing me because apparently you shouldn't come at the camera with the chainsaw. All right. Let's deal with the most dangerous snake in the room.
Hallelujah.
Shh. Shh. Anyways, beautiful people, let's get on deep. Into the aspen. I believe he's somewhere right here. Oh, he's not where I thought he was. This is the most dangerous time to be looking for a snake. When you thought he was one spot, and then he's in the other. Come on. Come on, where are you at? Oh no, where'd he go? I might have to use my bait. Oh! I almost got bit. That was crazy. All right. There we go. Oh my goodness, have a look at that. Leonardo DiCaprio, I almost want to touch him with my bare hands, but I don't try. Oh, you see him, you see him striking, he's crazy. Whoa, let's get him right into that enclosure, look at him. All right, he's just gonna do what he wants. There we go. That's a genuine hog nose setup. Would you look at that, boys and girls?
Yay!
Germs, buzzards, astronauts. Everyone watching this video right now, I hope you like, you share, you subscribe. Come on, look at this. Look at this! YouTuber face. So if you guys want to get a good starter snake, a hognose, a Western hognose typically is better because it just eats frozen thawed pinkies, mice, easier to deal with because I'm sure a lot of you guys don't want to go collecting toads if you had an Eastern hognose. So there you go, beautiful enclosure. And what are you still doing here? I told you, you can't be in this episode. We're trying to, you know, bump up the analytics, and apparently people think king cobras are too dangerous, or chainsaws. I can't figure it out. Comment below, do you think it's the chainsaw or the king cobra, or drinking the swamp water? I still don't know. And I said, dangerous axe. And that's when I jumped right in and swam with that grizzly bear. It was so fun. All right, you dangerous boy. We got your enclosure nice and clean. Let's get big old Kev back where he belongs. Say hello to Justine. All right, right there. Oops, you're going the wrong way, you dangerous boy. You're gonna get me demonetized. Get inside, get inside. Come on, big boy. I love you guys. I'll see you on the next one. Comment below what you want to see next. Comment below, do you think my last video got demonetized or limited ads because of the chainsaw, drinking swamp water, or dealing with a really angry king cobra? Anyways, I'll see you on the next one. Stay beautiful, stay safe, and most of all, follow your dreams. Do what makes you guys happy in life, because in the end, what else are you doing if you're not doing what makes you happy? Think about that. Love you guys. Won't stop breaking.